Hi, I would just like to give a quick disclaimer that I'm from the Philippines and I understand that the optometry curriculum may vary depending on what country you are in. What I'm about to share is based on my own personal experience. Thank you. As we go through this video, I will be flipping through my introduction to optometry and primary eye and vision care notes. This video is also a collaboration with my friend Abnormal Eye. You should definitely check his video out if you're an incoming optometry freshman in the Philippines. I will link the video in the description box below. Proceeding to why you click this video, tip number one is to start saving money as early as first year. The equipment you need during your higher years, the changes in uniform, and not to mention the money you need once you already have clinic requirements, is guaranteed to be a large amount. What I personally do, 70% of my allowance goes to my essentials or needs, like meals, water, or transportation. 15% goes to my wants. For example, a t-shirt you don't really need at the moment but you want to buy. Then the remaining 15% goes straight to my savings. Tip number two is somehow related to saving money, and that is to aim for a scholarship. Scholarships not only help you save money, they also train you to study better and be more disciplined. I go to Centro Escolar University and they have a wide variety of scholarship grants you can apply to. The most common one is the academic scholarship. To get 100% discount on your tuition and miscellaneous fees, you must maintain a general weighted average of 1.00 to 1.30, and to get a 50% discount, you must maintain a general weighted average of 1.31 to 1.50. Tip number three is to familiarize yourself with the platforms your school uses. In our school, we mainly use Canvas, and I never used Canvas before. It has a lot of features, so I suggest you take your time to explore every single one of them so you can avoid delays once you need to look for something. Tip number four is definitely something I wish I knew, which is to not stress yourself too much. During your first year, you don't really have a lot of strictly optometry-related subjects yet. You will only be required to take Introduction to Optometry and the Primary Eye and Vision Care. You do have laboratory requirements though, and you do have other subjects to take, but they are mostly things that I think you can handle, especially because most of the lessons were already covered in high school. Tip number five is to make new friends. I think it was a blessing in disguise that no one from my high school went to the same university I'm currently in, because I had no choice but to talk to people I just met. The population of the optometry students is not that huge compared to the other courses. People really do end up knowing one another at some point, so it's best to just put yourself out there and form new bonds. Lastly, tip number six is something I wish I did, which is to volunteer to shadow or help at an optical clinic the summer before your first year. I heard that those who went to high school at Centro Escolar had the chance to do this, and most of the optometry students are actually relatives of optometrists. But personally, I am neither of these things. I did not attend high school at Centro Escolar, and I do not have relatives who are optometrists. So whenever my professor or my classmates talk about optometry-related things, the information is all new to me, so applying to volunteer or to shadow at an optical clinic could be really helpful. That's all for this video. I hope this has been informative. If you have any questions or video suggestions, feel free to comment them down below or send me a message on my Instagram. I hope you have a productive day ahead.